everyone, Saturn here, giving another quick Vicky 3 tutorial. This time is going to be about technology, probably one of the best systems in the game that's been developed. There's a few things that they could probably add to it, but it's actually pretty solid. Let's get into it. The technology tree has three categories: production, military, and society. Each tech has a numerical number next to it. What this is telling you, or it's actually Roman numerals, is telling you what era it's in. And actually, you can see the bands here as well. This is like a darker area, and then it lightens up darker. So these are the different eras in the game. There's up to five. The reason why eras are important is that you get a penalty if you do not complete every tech from the previous era. So here we haven't completed lathe. What it does is it makes fractional distillation cost more. Usually it's 7,500 is the base cost. It's adding 1,850,000, a very weird number that they chose to do this, but it'll add that for every tech that you do not have completed in the previous era. Switching to Austria, we can see we have all our era tech ones completed. So looking at era two and fractional distillation again, we can see we're at 7,500. So the base cost of this. So how do we calculate weekly innovation? Well, we could hover over it. Every country has a base value of 50, and then every university will give more. These universities here are giving a plus four. Usually it's a plus two, but for every level. So these are probably both level two. We could check Bohemia and Austria really quick here. Let's see if we go under Bohemia. Yep, we have a university level two. So that's why we're getting a plus four innovation. Then there's other techs that we could get to have universities give even more innovation. So dialects is another one where we could hover over. It'll unlock philosophy department, which will now give us plus three innovation. And a way later tech down here, analytical philosophy, will unlock another department here and we'll get plus four. So eventually you can get to plus four innovation per level per university. However, there is a cap to weekly innovation, so you can't just go crazy teching through everything super fast. We hover over it here, we can see the maximum value is 100 innovation. So this is a base value again of 50, but you can see the other 50 is coming from literacy. So you want to increase the literacy of your nation if you want to increase the maximum that you want to be able to generate every week. The best way to increase the literacy of your nation is to invest in an education system. So we could go to our laws here. We could see that there's a few choices and under education system, but anyone will do, religious, private schools, or public. These are all different depending on what your nation and how developed they are. But getting any one of these, it will unlock an institution where you can start getting more education access to your people. So you see it's plus 10%. And then as you invest more in this and more bureaucracy, this will increase, which will over time increase your literacy. So you do want to try to get this started as soon as feasible. To increase the amount of levels of your education system, it's in the technology tree underneath society. Rationalism is one, which will increase it. Empiricism is another. You'll get another plus one max education to institution investment. Dialects, which we've already seen before, will give you another plus one. So you can look around the tree, but I think those are the major ones that'll help you increase your max education. You get to actively choose one research, and you'll have three other that are passive, and they happen over time and are random. And they'll actually increase through your technology spread. So you can see our spread here is 27 to 83. So that's kind of a random number. Every week it may invest anywhere between these numbers. How do we calculate tech spread? Well, you can hover over it and you can see that the base value is 25, and literacy again becomes very important. So plus 25. So not only is it for your passive technology spread as well as your active research. Technology spread is a catch-up mechanic, so it's really for the underdeveloped countries. For example, France doesn't get any research going on because no other countries have anything that they don't have. So you can see underneath society, nothing's going on extra. Same for military and same for production. So again, this is very useful for an underdeveloped country, but for ones that are already way ahead of the curve, it does nothing. One thing to note is you can also research techs that are also being passively researched. So if you look at the lathe here, we're actually getting our plus 50 from us, which we're actively researching, but then also the technology spread. So if you're trying to definitely get one tech really fast and you're lucky enough for it to start spreading to you, then actively researching it will make it come even faster. Underneath your laws and human rights and free speech, you can go for protected speech. This is a great one to get a plus 25% technology spread bonus. Of course, interest groups and their trades can have an impact on your technology as well. So industrialists, for example, have engines of progress. So if you make them happy enough, they'll give you a minus 10% technology cost. We're getting a minus 20% because their clout is over 20%. So they're getting double the bonus, which is really, really good. Armed forces or your military has one called Veteran Consultation, or probably maybe name something different depending on your nation. You get a minus 10% tech cost here, and the Intelligentsia, or whatever they're named again in your nation, you'll get a minus 10% society technology cost, again doubled if you can get their clout even stronger. There are also two interest groups that can hurt your technology. The first is your religious group. You can get a minus 10% education access if they're unhappy. The rural folk as well. If they're not happy, you'll get a minus 10% technology spread. Lastly, rulers can also have a character trait such as innovative, and what this will help is your technology spread by 10%. In summary, technology is split up into three groups: production, military, and society, and broken down by era. So you can see these here. You may want to complete all the techs in a given era so you don't get a penalty in your next. You want to also check your weekly innovation and see what your base cap is. The more your country's literacy is, the higher your cap will be. Also, you can generate more weekly innovation through universities, but that's usually mid to later game, depending on how advanced your nation is. If you're playing France, you may already be pumping out universities, but a lot of the other ones will require technology spread. What this does is a catch-up mechanic, which will help countries that are behind start to get those three passive techs that go on and help you just get caught up to the rest of the world. I hope you all found this video useful. I know technology is actually pretty straightforward out of all the systems in Vicky 3, so you may not have had too many questions, but hopefully you picked up a tip here or there. Hit that like, subscribe, notification button. They're free. And as always,
for the swarm.